Thank you, Jeremy. Good evening, everyone. What a lovely turnout. I have to say that I always get a little sense of panic when the Rotary Christmas tree lighting comes around, because it's officially the start of the Cayman Christmas season. And you know, from there on in, there's lots to do. My, how time flies. I can hardly believe that it's a year since we had the last one of these Christmas tree lightings. And while all of the Christmas tree lightings are special, as Jeremy alluded to, this one holds particular significance as it is the 50th anniversary of this annual event. I was a mere boy 50 years ago when the first Christmas tree lighting was held. But I can remember it because I was there. You see, my father is a charter member of the Rotary Club of Grand Cayman, and I'm happy to say he's here with us this evening. So it was only natural that my family came here for that first lighting so long ago. So long ago, but it seems like it was only yesterday. If you go on the club's Facebook page, you will see a description that sums up the Rotary Club of Grand Cayman. A dynamic and innovative service club, actively involved in worthwhile and sustainable projects at home and abroad, making a positive difference in the lives of all. How appropriate. For those who may not know, the Rotary Club of Grand Cayman was the first service club established in the Cayman Islands, receiving its charter on the 28th of January 1966, having been sponsored by the Rotary Club of Boston. Since then, it has sponsored other Rotary clubs and contributed much to the community at large. It was at the hands of this club that the Bonaventure Boys Home and Francis Borden Girls Homes were built, that Bartomeu Carnival came into existence, the fishing tournament, senior citizens party, and indeed this annual Christmas tree lighting all got their start. I could go on and on about the wonderful work that the Rotary Club of Grand Cayman has done throughout the Cayman Islands, but I won't. The services of the Rotary Club of Grand Cayman are vast and exemplify the motto of service before self. Indeed, when we think of service to others, we can immediately go to John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And it is to God's Son that we turn our attention, especially at this time of the year. I never grow tired of hearing the Christmas story, especially as it is told in the Gospel of Luke, verses 1 to 21. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to be registered, each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. It is that child, the Son of God, that we celebrate each Christmas. It is that child who grew into a mortal man without sin, who taught us grace, humility, love, kindness, and charity. And it is through the charity of the Rotary Club of Grand Cayman that we pause tonight to light this tree and usher in this wonderful time of Christmas. I do hope that each of us pauses during the hustle and bustle of this season to emulate the example given to us by the Christ. We are a brother's keeper, and we should seek out those who are in need this season and help them share with us this special time of year. I look forward to spending time with my family and friends this Christmas, not to necessarily exchange gifts, but to relish the time of peace and quiet and recall good times and memories, to cook some Cayman beef and bake some fruit cakes. My wish for all of us this Christmas is peace and prosperity for our country and our people. Thank you all for the opportunity to share this evening with you. On behalf of the government, my family, and myself, I wish each and every one of you a very blessed and happy Christmas. Thank you.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, yeah. Beautiful.
Cayman's got talent, right?
Christmas will
Christmas will be green and bright, the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night.
Billy, Billy, Kimaka is a wise way
to say Merry Christmas to you. Kalikimaka is a thing to say on a bright, a warm Christmas day. That's the island greeting that we send to you from the land where palm trees sway.
Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright,
the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night. Kalikimaka is a
a very Merry Christmas.
A very, very, very Merry Christmas to you.
Yeah.